Hi guys, welcome back to the channel. My name is Jashin. So this vlog is going to be completely in English. So usually I vlog in Tamil and English combined, but this is going to be a vlog completely in English. So I want to see how my subscribers react to this, and also how well you understand and are able to relate to this video. So what I'm going to do today is I'm going to show you my apartment, or rather the locality of the apartment where it is. I'm also going to show you the outer face. So I hope you guys like it. So as you guys know, if you've been following my previous videos, you'll know that I stay in Chengalpattu district and I'm going to move out soon, but I haven't revealed as to where I'm going to move out to. So that's going to be a surprise. Before I continue with today's vlog, there's a lake opposite my house and it's evening, and our house is actually quite a few kilometers away from the Vedanthangal bird sanctuary. But most of these migratory birds, they do come to nearby water bodies. In the lake opposite my house, you can see a lot of birds which are actually sitting on the water. There is some grass and foliage that has grown over the water, and you can see all these birds there. So I want you guys to have a look. So guys, I tried flying my drone towards the lake, but it's extremely windy. Battery on my drone suddenly reduced from 4 points to just 1 to 1.5 points. So right now it's just me and my second son who have come to our terrace. My second son is right over there and he's having a lot of fun. So even if I'm in the common area of my house, I don't remove my mask, and I actually double mask. I wear an N95 and I wear a surgical mask on top of that.
Dey, enga romba thooram odra?
Guys, I'll take you to the back side of my apartment. Rather, I'll walk to the other side of my terrace, so that you'll have a great look of where exactly I'm situated. So I'm walking towards the end of the terrace, so that I'll show you where exactly I'm located. So that should give you a where to invest in real estate if you're looking at the suburbs of Chennai, actually towards the south of Chennai. Like to purchase a land or flat somewhere in the suburbs of Chennai or somewhere closer to Chennai, starting from Dindivanam to Chengalpattu, this should be a good opportunity. Just 8 to 8:15 in the evening, so we've come down to the park area. So it's mostly deserted, it's just our family here. But we usually come when the crowd is less. So I still keep wearing my mask just to ensure that I reduce the risk of getting infection. So my kids are in the background. I think in the bokeh effect and the darkness, you might be able to see them a little. So in this video, what I intend telling you guys is I'm going to explain the rationale as to why I chose this flat in this particular location near Chennai. So my work location is in Chengalpattu district. It is very close to Chengalpattu. It's just 5 kilometers from from the Chengalpattu periphery, and it's close to 7 kilometers from the heart of Chengalpattu. So I purchased a flat 3 years ago. So I'm going to remove my mask. So since my work location was close to Chengalpattu, I purchased a house 20 kilometers towards Chennai. So here I have been all along for the past 3 years. So I think I've been here since 2018-19, that time frame. So it's been 3 years solid. So I'm quite happy with my purchase, and it wasn't too heavy on my pocket, and it wasn't extremely cheap as well. So I'll tell you what were the conditions that I had before I filtered down, and satisfyingly I purchased this flat. So my primary thing was I wanted to be close to Chennai, but I did not want the expense of Chennai and the traffic of Chennai. So what I did is I purchased 8 kilometers from Tambaram. So my location is 8 kilometers from Tambaram. So I'm not in the Chennai corporation limit. It's outside. In Tamil they say it as Urachi. So corporation is Nagarachi. So this is Urachi. So over here, 8 kilometers from Tambaram, which is not too far off, and I'm not in the hustle and bustle of the city. And also GST road isn't too crowded at certain vantage points like Vandalur, Gudvanjiri, Maramelanagar, Singaparamal Koil. So this particular location was pretty good for me. And secondly, I am not too interior, and I have also not purchased bang on GST road. So I am situated 500 meters to 750 meters from GST road, which isn't too far because I travel by bike or by car. Hardly takes me 2 to 3 minutes to reach the main road. If you go pretty interior, you can purchase lands or plots or flats at a very cheap price, but it again comes at the cost of commute, and for other basic amenities you would have to travel. The second thing is, this kind of fell into my budget because I usually don't prefer communities which have a swimming pool or which has too much of common area. So this was having 70 to 74 plus flats, and it is just two blocks, and it's got a covered car park for my flat, and there is all children's play area which has a jogging park and a couple of swings and a slide. So I think that was pretty good enough for my family. I've got a family with two kids. One guy is doing his second grade, the other guy is doing his LKG. Both of them are in CBSE. So that is pretty, I think for our family, I bought a 2 BHK flat with around 1000 square feet built up area. So of course the carpet area will be much lesser, but this was more than enough for me. So my primary thing was, I didn't want too big a house because I've got kids and I would want to keep a note on them, and this was not my primary investment. So I'm also not going to be staying here permanently. I'm going to rent it out soon. So this 3 years of stay itself is a big deal. So I'm going to a different part of town, and if you've been watching my previous videos, you will know that I'm really in the process of shifting. So this COVID and the lockdowns is what is delaying the process. So what I would say is, look for the location and look at the locality. One thing that I would like to say here is that I always look at flats which are on the east side of GST, which are located to the east of the railway track. Reason being is, all the properties and all the real estate that is situated on the west side of GST, that is western side of the railway track, had population settlement much earlier, and hence all of them are low-lying areas. So even with a little bit of rain, you can see a lot of water stagnation, and during heavy rains you can see flooding in almost all areas. So you can see old Perangalathur, which is west Perangalathur, you have water flooding in west Urappakkam, water flooding in west Gudvanjiri. So if you ask me that does the east side not get flooded, that is not true, because east Gudvanjiri, say Nellikuppam Gudvanjiri road, also gets flooded. So the thing is, the western side is more prone to flooding as they were settled much earlier and they're extremely low lying. So I've seen flats on the western side where the first floor itself is in line with the railway track. So you can see what the ground floor and the car park situation is. I have to say about my flat, I've got a covered car park, I've got a children's play area, I've got a decent 2 BHK, 1000 square feet built up area apartment. It's got a balcony and a service area and attached bathroom and a common bathroom. So it's for the four of us, it's pretty it's good enough. So I've already shown, I'll show you a drone shot of my apartment soon. I'll show you a drone shot of my community soon. So if you want a house tour, please let me know in the comments below. And this is the first vlog that I'm doing after a long, long time, since the first set of videos that I've shot on my channel in English. So this is completely in English. So guys, let me know if you like this video.